I had a request to make, say, a drawing of a radio mixer circuit. In general, I don't do these kinds of requests, but anyway, in this case, I want to make an exception. Here I is my, say, all the things that I wanted to tell, but I want to keep it very short. The transistors that you can use, the BF245 is an NFET, it's here, drain, source, gate. The BC547 is an N-silicon MESA transistor, emitter, base, collector. Another NFET that you can use when I am talking in this video is the BF256B. It works like the BF245B, drain, source, gate, and the BF199 is a typical NPN silicon bipolar transistor with a good amplification factor, say between 100 and 120, and the pin connections are BEC, so base, emitter, collector. Perhaps I have to make two videos. I will surely do my best to say make this video, etc., etc. I swipe off now all the transistors because I want to have my hands free. A radio mixer. The problem in this request is that I only know one type of mixer, and that is what we call in the Netherlands the so-called snelheidsmodulator. So that's a one transistor radio mixer. There are much more circuits where such a circuit is used, the mixer circuit is used, but anyway. So mixer. And the word mixer for shortwave radios, and the accent must be very simple. So it does not have ideal properties, this mixer. And another interesting thing is that the word mixer is in fact not the right word. What the circuit does is frequency transformation, and that's much more important. We always read in electronic magazines, radio magazines, the mixer circuit, but nothing is mixed. There are no two frequencies mixed. That's, say, a bad idea. Anyway, we have here again the positive lead, like in many earlier videos that I have showed. Here we have the negative lead. And also in such a mixer circuit, I keep saying that it's a mixer, but anyway, we need a kind of decoupling. That was also in the earlier video, say the resistor here is 100 ohms up to 470 ohms, the voltage is 12 volts. The decoupling capacitor is, say, 100 microfarad. Much more in earlier videos. Say, the resistor here is 100K. And the capacitor is also, not also, but anyway, 100 nanofarad. And when I draw this circuit, for this circuit, a radio mixer for the shortwave band, I'm very aware of the fact that this decoupling unit could also differ. So, say, especially when you work on shortwave bands, it could be that this decoupling capacitor must be 220 nanofarads or 100 nanofarads. That depends. It can give on other frequency bands another, say, suppression, another type of decoupling. That's what it's all about. Decoupling means that we have here a radio circuit, and the radio frequency, say, signals out of the oscillator that enter the mixer circuit, must not travel on the power supply lead. And I use here a resistor, but when you look to circuits of the 1920s, often a choke coil was used here. So not a resistor, but a choke coil. And I'm not going to say, explain that better. But the only idea is that with a choke coil, a DC can flow properly to the circuit. But on the other hand, the AC, say the radio signal, is, say, choked out here so that it cannot travel to other stages of the radio. Study, say, old radio magazines. They are on the World Wide Web. There are many, many circuits about this issue. But anyway, I use here a resistor that has a kind of the same effect, though it is not a frequency dependent smoothing. Anyway, it works. That's the most important thing. So let's go to the mixer circuit. We have here, of course, a resistor. We have here the mixer transistor. And say it is a BC547B. It can work up to 9 megahertz. For other or better properties, use the BF199. That's here. And of course, like I told in earlier videos, every transistor needs its proper bias. So also this, say, mixer needs a proper bias. This transistor amplifies, say, maximum through 300 times. That's very, very good. But anyway, like I told earlier, the amplification is related to the ratio between the collector resistor and the emitter resistor, and that's very, very important, the capacitor here. But I want to gum out now this circuit. You can use this as a mixer, by the way. So, and then I mean a frequency transformation circuit. Send in here frequency X. And also you can send in frequency A. Via capacitor, of course. And when you say change the bias of the mixer transistor, you will get a, say, intermediate frequency out compared to the this frequency and that frequency. But anyway, this is kind of sloppy, though it will surely work. And I want to give a much better, say, typical radio circuit. We have here now not a resistor, but a coil. And that's very, very important. For instance, these kinds of coils, I call them IF filters, but anyway, they are on many frequencies. So let's see what we can do when we have a radio mixer with a certain coil. I have to gum this all out anyway. So that's good. In the collector lead we have a coil. Here's the core of that coil, and here we have the output coil. And this one is tuned to say 455 kilocycles. Here we need a resistor, and here we have the bias of that mixer unit. Here is the BC547B, works up to 9 megahertz, not higher. Better use is again the BF199, but anyway, here we send in the radio signal coming from the front end. And I see now on my camera that I have 12 minutes, so I need much more, say, a time to do this. So this will be part one. Anyway, front end. I will give a circuit of a front end radio transistor amplifier in the next video. Anyway, here we have the 455 kilocycles filter. You don't have to use a coil, so not say such a coil, but you can also use another type of filter for the IF to filter out the IF frequency. That could be this, and this is a ceramic filter, so that's another opportunity. But let's focus now on the circuit with the coil. And it's important, I haven't drawn that properly, that here is a resistor. That resistor is, say, 1K. Here is the coil. The coil has, by the way, a hot end and a cold end. That's important. That means that in certain cases it's a better idea to reverse, say, this electrode with this electrode to get a better, say, energy out. So, for instance, this one. And you can also see, and when you open such a IF coil, you can see that there is a frequency-dependent capacitor on one side here, and here is the outcoupling capacitor. And it's tuned to 455 kilocycles in this case. So mixing, what's mixing? Mixing is frequency transformation. That's the most important thing to tell. Here we send in the signal of the front end, so the high F amplifier. My camera will stop within a minute or so. One signal here, the value of the capacitor here is critical in regarding the mixing, the frequency transformation effect. And here we can also mix in the signal out of the VFO. Variable frequency oscillator. It's connected to the positive and the negative, and that capacitor is critical. So there must be a balance between, say, the signal coming out of the antenna amplifier into the mixer and the say the magnitude of the signal that comes out of the VFO, and in that case you have here, say, the difference frequency between the, say, antenna frequency and the frequency of the VFO. I will explain more in the next video, because my camera will surely stop within, say, 1 minute or so. Thanks for watching.